Okay, so today, taking another break from import export YAML nonsense, because that's kind of just dragging on as the refinement just takes a while to think through and all that stuff. I'm going to see if I can add something a bit more interesting today. What that will be, I guess, I mean, physics. Yeah, I can probably add a basic physics system to this using the bullet library. That sounds reasonable. Yeah, okay. So the first thing I'm going to need is to bring in bullet library. So I guess I'll add it from here. I'll put it into the Bringup for the moment. So I believe there's a find package for it. So yeah, there's a find bullet available, so it's required. Close that up, and then we'll add it as a library. CLI, so it'll be the libraries. Is there an include directory? No, there isn't. Okay, we add those. Make sure it, you can link them in. Yes, maybe. Okay. We go into the application. We'll just add something into the initialize area. We'll just include bullet, maybe. Or maybe we just need like BT. Okay, bullet dynamics common. Leaves the base. Can at least find that header. Yeah, it can find it. So we need a couple. Let me just double check the documentation over here on the other window. I need a number of items to start with. Okay. Let's put this in the top here. Need pointer for BT broad phase or face. DB VT broad phase. There's nothing in there. Defaults collision configuration. Starts out with a collision config dot get all this gets put into int pointer bt discrete dynamics world. Takes in the collision dispatcher.get. Solver and collision config. Does it build and link? Obviously, I have the include directories. Do I have the library linked in? Like, will this crap out if it can't find these news? No, it looks all right. Okay. Set gravity, okay. It's a BT Vec 3. Okay. So let's say 0, negative 9.8, 0. With assuming y is up. Have to do something about that. Then we need to add rigid bodies. Let's just say rigid body construction info. Okay, physics body, rigid body. Okay, so what we want to create is rigid body. It's supposed to be a kind of like a weird this construction info thing. It takes in a number of items, including the mass. So we'll just say the mass is 1.5. Or I'd actually have to have. Well, no, I'll just let it fall, whatever. 1.f. What else we got? Really? Is this, oh, here we go. Is it like part of the, there it is. Motion state, which I don't have. The collision shape, which I don't have. Inertia, which is that, and everything else is defaulted. Okay. Okay, so I need a collision shape. Physics world. Shape. Rigid body. Just take in the basic collision shape. Box shape. Okay. Oh, the BT vector 3. Of the 3, okay. One, one, one. Got the shape. So the collision shape is that. Get. So the rigid body is, where's the constructor for this thing? Where is it? There it is. It takes it. Okay, so new BT rigid body. Takes in this. Okay, we have everything. Do we need to add it to the world? So add rigid body, and it'll be the rigid body we have. If I want to get information, okay, there's two. How do I get data back out? I mean, that's what the motion state's for, right? I think. Do motion state. Okay, when a motion state is provided, the rigid body will initialize its world transform the motion state. In this case, that is ignored. Okay. Okay, rigid body CI. MC. Start will transform is, what is this?
BT.
Okay, I am going to need something useful for. Okay, you know what? BT GLM conversion HPP should work. So we get. I'm just gonna just front load all of the conversions right now. Include BT dynamics bullet. Dynamics.h. Okay. And I need quaternions, which means extension HPP. So we got what? GLM vec 3. Vector 3 GLM to BT. Vector 3, we'll just do the opposite. There's a BT transform, which is, where do I get this from? You, there. What are you made of? What are you made of? You don't know who you are. Open that. Nope, it's not even there. Okay. Open that. Open this to open that. Ugh. Okay, let me open it on the side. Open file. User include bullet linear math. BT quaternion transform. Okay. Here it is. It's generated from a quaternion and a BT vector 3. Other BT transforms. Multiplications of the two transforms. What is this? Is this like a mat? No. It's not a 4x4 matrix. Rotation and translation. So it's close. Very close. That's smaller. It's not 4x4. It's 3x3 plus 3. So it's 12 instead of 16 by... Well, 12 by instead of 16 numbers. It's a bit smaller. Okay. Okay, are there any other ones? Okay, so it's just generated that way. So, BT transform. transform. So we'll take in a 4x4 matrix. And then I need to go the other way. So it'd be first technically. Okay. I can probably just do them in line for the moment. So, first one. What the hell? Skew symmetric? Okay, whatever. Don't know. So that's those two. So we can actually, no, just leave them like that. Quaternion. It doesn't even have a quaternion. No, there it is, right there. How does it? X, Y, Z, W. Okay. Oh, whoops, wrong way around. Okay, I know that this one takes W first. So, no, hit W first. It's not bad, it's quaternion. This was XYZW. Okay, and then these ones, so GLM. No, it's the other way around. Macro major. So yeah, okay. So it'll be get. We can also set from it. Okay. Get from starting address. BT scalar, it'll be floats. This is also going to be float, so if I read cast of glm, sorry, not that. BT scalar of matrix like that. Okay. And this one BT transform can be generated from these two, right? Set origin, set rotation, or I can just do this. Okay. Interpret cast again. Then return that. Do 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 do. Not really sure if I just should just leave it here as inline functions or for the moment I guess I'll leave it like that. Do this. Got a transform. Now what was I doing? Start world transform. Equals, it was a transform. So let's say it's sitting at plus 4. So it's just like, that and then close that up, and it's glm vec 3 0 4 0. Oh, I got it the other way around. Yes. The added the rigid body, then what I want to do is I want to do like, can I get Get motion states. Get orientation. Get trans. Get world transform. That'll work. Plus I, we do that. We're gonna call this a whole bunch of times. We're gonna call fizz world process. Simulate. Step simulation. Time step of 0.1 seconds, I guess. Do that. Can I get stuff back out? How do I get stuff back out of it? So I could get origin. There's a get origin. Right, let's see what happens. It should just continuously fall because there's nothing, nothing to stop it. Okay. Oh, right, because the logger isn't initialized yet. Yes. Put that up a little bit, shall we? And do that again. Well, that's pretty okay by me. All right, so let's add a second rigid body that just sits just underneath, except it's static. So it's a zero. It's also a body, same collision shape. But the is zero. Zero is just means it has no mass, so it's static. We add that as well. Same thing. Okay. So rather than going to negatives, it should stay one above, maybe, or 0.5. I'm not sure where the center. So it's probably like plus 0.5, plus 0.5. Probably sitting at one. Or two. So it drops, and then it kind of stops, and then it slowly comes back to a steady state here. Drops just a little bit underneath two, and slowly goes back up to two. I presume if we kind of left it for a little bit longer, it'll slowly creep back up to two and just stay there. Because that's, what, 0.1, so 10 per second for a few seconds. Nope, okay. Right. Well, this is the very basics of the bullet physics engine use. So now I need to kind of transform this into more of a kind of system. And I need to add not rigid bodies, collision shapes for as a resource, as a common resource. Okay, one of the first things I'll need is a pool of the damn things. So much like this, I guess. Where's position? Or do I just, like, state data, state pools are all just maps? Okay. Rigid body. Just kind of do that. We get too crazy. I want to have my own type, which kind of expands on it for the moment. Well, or it's just the same thing, actually. I think that'll be fine. Because I don't really have anything else to add to it yet. So, yeah. BT bullet dynamics common, and we're just using fizz. Body. That. We're going to include that down here in state data, state pools. It wouldn't even be this because it'd be a unique pointer to an actual object, wouldn't it? Problem. Can we add that? I'm going to need some kind of system world. Because one thing we're going to actually need, if I don't want to like add and remove things all of the time. I'm going to have like a yeah, how do I determine when I can when something's been added, whether or not it's worth putting in yet? Unless unless this becomes like an expansion, or rather, something like this, like bool in world starts with false. Something like that. That would work. Well, it'll only add on when we're adding it. If we're trying to remove it, okay. I'm not really sure how to go with this. I'm really not. Okay, it'd be something like this. We need float mass. We need the collision, like SOFO ID. It'll be like the collision. Whether or not it exists in the world depends on whether or not this is null pointer or not, rather. We can add, for the moment, a destructor to this. We'll need a some kind of something to do with processing. It's like an init. This would also like this would take in like state pools, I guess. Because what init would do. They would initialize these common items. Or even, I wouldn't even need to. Realistically, I could just do it like this. Rather than init, okay, we'll have which can take in this type. We'll have a temporary collision type, which is always going to be a box right now. I guess clang format's dead. But takes in this type. Thing that processes the tick, which will be takes in the time, I believe. Like I should have time available in here somewhere. This is all initialization. Here we go, somewhere in here. Okay. So we do have time. Double check where, what we got for rigid body? No. Okay, I need to is it all saved? Okay, it's back online. Max sub steps, fixed time step, 1 out of 60. So yeah. Probably going to require some special timing to keep it up to date properly. Otherwise, fizz world. Now, what we'd have to do is we need to create. We have this, we have these. Need to set, okay. Need to call that. Get rid of all this stuff. Get rid of the collision shape. We have that. that. This will be goes that. Create it. Return, otherwise we're doing this. This system is currently under the assumption that I only have one physics world, which will not hold for long, but it's an okay thing to start with. Okay, so these are the items we have. Let's do this. We add init physics. We have add rigid body. Remove. back to this. We'll have two of them. So what we're going to do, okay, we just get, just trash the rest of this back to what it was. We now have this, which is going to include physics system. Mm-hmm. We're going to go down to here. We'll add one. I thought this was added. Rigid bodies. For render mesh ID. It's not even here, is it? It's very interesting. I thought state. Okay. Oh, fizz frigid body. That's why. The mass is that, the rest of it doesn't really matter yet. Okay, we'll add rigid body call right here. We're using something like this. No. No. We'll need the state pools. We'll have at least init physics, though. We need to have that. Okay, we go in here, he's got the state pools. So he goes through auto and iterator of state dot rigid bodies. He goes through, he finds any bodies that need to be added. Just adds, just add rigid body. Have to go through and like if get transform, get origin. Really? Okay. Okay, it still can't find it. Rigid body found not found. Why? Because it's a private, isn't it? And not public, perhaps? I set it as private, yeah. The include directories weren't being transitioned down the to the main application, which is built this. Wasn't getting these. Well, it's carrying on way down there, so yay. And it just keeps going way, way down there. Way faster than it should be, really. What's the time passed? Seriously. Oh, it's the absolute time, isn't it? It's about by 1,000. So rather, I need like the frame time dot. This realistically. Milliseconds. Okay, that's a lot better. Still a bit speedy, but okay, there's a okay, around here somewhere there should be like a time elapsed in seconds that I have. Oh, right there actually. Try to calculate here. What? Simulation clock, the time elapsed is what? This is the. Like, is this the total time or just since the last tick? Okay, yes. So this makes sense, I guess. I mean, it normalized the movement of everything else, so this is probably the actual number I'm looking for. Yeah, it looks pretty realistic there. Okay, we've got process physics, we got the Y position, so that's seemingly kind of coming together. It's still really, really awful. Of course, I also need to change it so, like, if
It'll need to take the data in the position data from... You know what?
I've already spent an hour and a bit on this. I'll actually call it there with this rickety old terrible system. Not even really a system. It's a something that exists. It's a basis from which I can launch further next time. All right, that's it. Cheers.